बेटा अगर ये अटेंडेंस ऐसी रहेगी तो इट इज गोइंग टू बी डिफिकल्ट टू कंडक्ट योर मल्टीपल असेसमेंट, और फिर जितने प्रेजेंट रहेंगे मैं उन्हीं में मल्टीपल असेसमेंट कर लूंगी। लेट्स लुक इन टू द चैप्टर पॉवर्टी एज अ चैलेंज फ्रॉम एन इकोनॉमिक्स पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू।
सायरा मैम,
विल दिस काइंड ऑफ अर्निंग अलाउ वन टू बाय नेसेसिटीज फॉर सर्वाइवल? How comfortable is this bed? How safe would one's health be if utensils are washed and food cooked in this water? Is the right to education only for a few? Then what about their right? How many would like to earn their livelihood in this manner? How painful is the pang of hunger? Ask one who has experienced this kind of extreme hunger. This is also a home. How many would like to live in such a place? But for some, this is also a luxury, as many are forced to live on the street. Can you guess what this line is for? It is a line at a clinic in a slum area for outpatients. Imagine getting healthcare here. We complain about amenities in our classrooms, but this is also a classroom. Is this the childhood we would like to give to the next generation? Do they not deserve better at this age? Think about this and discuss. India is estimated to have a third of the world's poor. This means that India is the single largest country that has the concentration of so many poor people. The people who are classified as poor can be described as people who have little or no money or goods to support their day-to-day needs. This condition is termed as poverty. The common method of identifying the poor is to assess if their income or consumption level fulfills their basic needs. If a person earns enough to meet these needs, they are said to be above the poverty line. If not, they are said to be below the line of poverty. Thus, the line of poverty, which is an imaginary line, determines the minimum level of income needed by a person to fulfill their necessities. In 2005, The uniform standard set by World Bank for poverty specifies that the minimum income to allow sustainability of an individual should be equivalent of $1.25 per person per day. However, in India, the poverty line is determined by the average daily food requirement of a person. This is based on the calorie intake of food items. If a person earns enough to meet this requirement, the said person is said to be above the poverty line. If not, he is defined as poor. To understand this better, let us see the examples of Radha, a casual worker on a farm in rural India, and Kamala, a domestic worker in the city. The task done by Radha is far more strenuous than the task done by Kamala, as she works under harsher physical conditions. So, the calorie intake for their basic sustenance also varies. Since Radha leads a more demanding life, she requires a higher daily calorie intake as opposed to Kamala. Who do you think would need to earn more, Radha or Kamala? One would have thought Radha, as she needs a higher calorie intake. But that is not the correct answer. Kamala would require more since the prices of goods and services is much higher in the urban areas. On the basis of the above, in the year 2000, the Government of India fixed the poverty line for a person living in a rural area to ₹328 and for one living in an urban area to ₹454. Hence, a family of five living in a rural area that earns less than ₹1,640 per month, while a similar sized family in an urban area earning ₹2,270 would both qualify as families living below the poverty line. This estimation of the poverty line is usually moderated every 5 years to adjust the change in cost of living. As per the survey of 2005, these rates have been adjusted to ₹368 per person per month in rural areas and ₹560 per person per month in urban areas. Poverty is said to be a vicious circle. Once a person is caught in the cycle, then its effect is visible on multiple fronts. Let us see some of the social indicators of poverty. Let's take the case of Radha and her husband Raman. Both are seasonally employed on the farms and are paid meager salaries. They are unable to meet the food requirements, and so all the members of the family suffer from malnutrition. Children have little or no opportunity to attend school. They are forced to start working at an early age to add to the income of the family. Lack of education makes them vulnerable. The family suffers from undernourishment. As a result, they fall ill very often. However, they cannot afford good healthcare facilities and can be inflicted with serious illnesses. Lack of education and healthcare hamper the ability to get jobs once they reach adulthood. As a result, the family continues to live in the cycle of poverty. Their health and even survival is at stake since they lack access to both safe drinking water and adequate sanitation facilities. In recent times, two new dimensions have been added as indicators of poverty. They are social exclusion and vulnerability. Most people think that the poor should live only with other poor people. They are not allowed to mingle with socially better off people. This is known as social exclusion. As a result of social exclusion, the poor are excluded from accessing many benefits like employment, healthcare, and education. Do you think the poor can overcome this situation? Yes, but they will face a number of obstacles. That's because the poor have a greater chance of remaining poor in the future. This is referred to as vulnerability. In fact, certain sections such as members of the backward castes, widows, or physically handicapped are considered more vulnerable to being poor. As a result of vulnerability, there is only a minimal chance for the poor to increase their income as they lack assets, education, good health, and very often are unemployed. Think about this and discuss.
Extra question of climate chapter. थोड़ा क्लाइमेट चैप्टर में और चीजें हम देखेंगे, थोड़ा सा उसे और पढ़ेंगे, उसके बाद करते हैं एक्स्ट्रा क्वेश्चंस। तुम लोग अब क्लास अटेंड नहीं कर रहे हो टाइम से, बिकॉज यू आर नॉट सबमिटिंग योर असाइनमेंट, यू आर नॉट डूइंग द असेसमेंट वर्क प्रॉपरली, तो मैं कैसे तुम्हें जो है एंथुसियाज्म के साथ पढ़ाऊं? It is difficult from my point of view as well to remain enthusiastic when nobody seems to be taking interest and taking things seriously. Any question in the video that you have seen, we were not discussing something that you do not know. It's just a thinking question that how certain sections of society are more vulnerable to poverty and how the cycle of poverty remains constant and how a poverty line is drawn and is it sufficient to declare someone poor on those basis जो उसके indicators हैं, जो उसके given indicators हैं line के, वो हमें पता होने चाहिए क्यों हैं, उसके क्या limitations हैं हमें वो पता होने चाहिए, then the social factors which are responsible for poverty, we need to know how they are responsible and how we can eradicate them. ये main issues हैं जो हमें इस chapter में discuss करने हैं. We should know about all these things. If you do not understand what is going on in the video, feel free to ask. नहीं तो I'll move ahead. Anyone?
मैम जो इसमें price का मैम जो इसमें मैम प्राइस बताए थे मैम रूरल एरिया और अर्बन एरिया के बीच में मैम मैम गवर्नमेंट सेट करती है कि कोई और
तो गवर्नमेंट सेट करती है कि ये पॉवर्टी लाइन है जो इसके पास इससे कम पैसे का जो इससे कम कमाता है दैट गोज अंडर देयर जो इससे ज्यादा कमाता है दैट गोज अंडर देयर और ये सब वो इस बेसिस पर डिसाइड कर रहे हैं कि इंसान को कितनी कैलोरी की जरूरत है Women need different number of calories, but यहाँ पर सीधा सवाल ये आता है, being a human being, क्या केवल खाना ही basic need है? क्या केवल एक certain amount of money can decide if your living conditions are good or not? Humanistic point of view से हमें ये चीजें सोचनी पड़ेंगे. कि पॉवर्टी केवल एक लाइन बना देने से कि इसके ऊपर जो है वो पुअर नहीं है जो इसके नीचे है वो पुअर है जो पॉवर्टी लाइन होती है जिसे गरीबी रेखा कहते हैं उसके नीचे के लोगों के लिए स्पेशल कार्ड्स है बहुत सारे स्कीम्स है बहुत सारे गवर्नमेंट के इनिशिएटिव्स हैं लेकिन उस पॉवर्टी लाइन वाली लाइन में पहुंचने के लिए भी तो आपको गवर्नमेंट को सेटिस्फाई करना पड़ेगा गवर्नमेंट को कैसे सेटिस्फाई किया जाता है अदिति वी विल सी व्हाट वी कैन डू अभी तो जो आगे के असाइनमेंट्स है उस पर आप काम करिए विल कम बैक टू यू आफ्टर वी आर डन विद एवरीथिंग डू नॉट वरी यू हैव टू थिंक अबाउट दैट आई नो दैट नोबडी हियर कम्स फ्रॉम बिलो पॉवर्टी लाइन बट यू हैव टू इमेजिन अ काइंड ऑफ लाइफ जो हमें दिखाने की कोशिश करी जा रही है स्टोरी लेट्स वेट फॉर अ लिटिल टाइम अभी ये थोड़ा चैप्टर फ्लो में चल रहा है अगर बचता है टाइम आई विल डू दैट बेसिकली आई एम नॉट एट ऑल एंथुसियास्टिक अबाउट लिसनिंग टू योर स्टोरीज एनी मोर बट आई विल डू दैट नॉनदरलेस थोड़ा सा चैप्टर कंटेंट आगे कवर हो जाए
The chief minister of the state is visiting one of the district headquarters of his state. His purpose is to find out how the targeted anti-poverty programs are being executed in the district. The first to speak at this meeting is Kaushalya. She is here to narrate the success story of a group of women who were assisted in poverty alleviation through the Swarna Jayanti Gram Swarozgar Yojana or the SGSY scheme.
Good evening, sir. About 2 years ago, a group of 50 women, including me, lived below the poverty line. Life was difficult until we were trained in fruit processing by a non-government organization. This training equipped us with the knowledge to set up a fruit processing unit in our village. For this, we got an assistance of rupees 8 lakhs under the SGSY scheme for buying machinery and other packaging inputs. Today, the unit produces and markets a variety of jams and pickles. This has helped the families of all those involved, as now we all have sufficient means to buy the basic necessities in life.
The next to speak at this function is Raghav, who was living in abject poverty. But thanks to the National Rural Employment Guarantee Act, NREGA, he is assured of 100 days of wage employment so long as he volunteers to do unskilled manual work for the period. This scheme is applicable in the rural areas. Under it, the government provides employment for 100 days in a year to every household registered under the scheme.
Sir, my family and I have benefited a lot under the scheme. We are a family of seven, of which my wife and I are the only ones who work as casual laborers. We work on farms in the months that require sowing and harvesting. In the other months, we have no source of earning a livelihood. So NREGA comes as a big help to us as it guarantees me and my family food for 100 days in the year. In these months, we are employed in jobs like road construction. What is good about this scheme is, once I register under this scheme and employment is not provided to me within 15 days, then I get a daily unemployment allowance until the government is able to provide me some form of employment.
Bimla too has something to share. She hails from a village which was once backward and lacked even basic amenities. However, due to implementation of the Pradhan Mantri Gramodaya Yojana, her village is now one of the many to be provided with basic amenities. The center gives money to the state governments for setting up projects like housing, electrification, and water in the villages.
Sir, you cannot imagine the sorry state in which we lived until a few years ago. Our village was cut off from the rest of the district. We had neither electricity nor a safe source of drinking water. The only well of the village was showing signs of drying up. The village lacked a proper drainage system. But thanks to some kind soul, some call him the district collector, we soon found these facilities reach us one by one. This has transformed our village completely and as a result given us great joy. Very recently, we have a new primary school set up. I am looking forward for the day when my child will be able to read and write.
The Chief Minister is happy to hear the progress of these schemes. He also wants the people to know about certain other schemes. For instance, the Prime Minister Rozgar Yojana or PMRY, which provides employment to youth in both rural and urban areas.
He informs the group that not only does the government want to create jobs, but also wants people to set up their own businesses. This is possible under the Rural Employment Generation Program. Under the program, unemployed rural youth are encouraged to build entrepreneurial qualities so that they can start their own business enterprise. All these schemes seem to be giving employment opportunities. Is there no way we poor can buy food at subsidized rates? In response, the Chief Minister informed the group about the Antyodaya Yojana. Under this scheme, the poorest of the poor and the needy elderly are given food grains at subsidized rates through the public distribution system.
The government has many programs to assist us. What I like all about them all is they are not charity programs. They are more like self-help schemes, so we poor can maintain our dignity.
All these schemes promote economic growth and create opportunities for the poor. Even better, they nurture the qualities of self-reliance and self-worth in an individual.
So all these schemes that are on your screen या आपके book में दिए हुए हैं, इसका आप एक table बनाएंगे, that will be the year, second the name of the scheme, third main features of the scheme, and for that you will use the latest information that we have available. और economics के मैं पहले भी बता चुकी हूँ, जितने भी chapters होंगे इसके अंदर जो भी data है, जो poverty line का data है और जितनी भी चीजों का data है, ये सब NCERT के latest edition में से आप लोग देख लेंगे. If you even have old book, no problem. लेकिन आप लोग उसके जो figures हैं, वो latest printed edition के हिसाब से उसे change कर दें. So anything you feel like asking? Okay, so let's continue the storytelling work that we were doing. And I'll start with Pranav Srivastav. Yes, Pranav, your turn. If you have any issue, you can write it in the chat box also, क्योंकि अगर मुझे instantly reply नहीं आएगा, I will consider you are not present in the class and I will mark you absent. Okay, so somebody can tell Pranav that he has been marked absent. Next, Pragya, your turn.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, the story is about the barber, the son. The story goes on how Humayun was dear to barber. Once he had fallen ill, there was no hope of recovery. Barber stand near his bed, prayed to Allah that his life may be taken to save his son's life. Very soon Humayun get recover and Babur fall ill and die.
बेटा दिस वाज एग्जैक्टली अ 5 लाइन स्टोरी. अब मैं तुम्हें इस पे मार्क्स क्या दूं? स्टोरी तो ठीक है, इट इज अ स्टोरी, इट इज हिस्टोरिकल, बट इस पे मैं तुम्हें कैसे मार्किंग कर सकती हूँ? तुम खुद मुझे बताओ. ये तो एक फैक्ट हो गया. आई विल गिव यू अनदर चांस, जब सबका हो जाएगा आई विल गिव यू अनदर चांस. फाइंड समथिंग मोर एलैबोरेट, कुछ स्टोरी जैसा तो हो. फाइन. यस मायरा, आर यू रेडी टू डू? कैन यू हियर मी?
यस मैम.
यस प्लीज कंटिन्यू.
Om Shri Sai Ram, I am Myra Ishan Sheikh and I am going to tell a story about Tunguska event. The Tunguska event, a 1908 explosion estimated at 1000 times more powerful than the atomic bomb dropped on Hiroshima. The Tunguska event occurred around 7 a.m. local time on June 30, 1908 near the Putkamanya Tunguska River in Siberia. Witnesses saw a bluish light nearly as bright as the sun moving across the sky. What followed an estimated 15 megaton explosion which knocked over about 80 million trees in butterfly shape pattern. This also sent a shock wave throughout parts of Europe and Asia, registering as far away England. Further, the atmospheric pressure change was also significant enough to be measured all way in Great Britain. Another interesting side effect of this blast was that for several days after the blast, throughout most of Asia and Europe, the night sky glowed. It was so bright that people as far as China reportedly were able to read in the middle of the night, but the glow of the sky. For a long time, there was much debate over exactly that caused this, but today scientists are reasonably certain it was a comet. The comet must have been around 30-40 meters across, and must have been traveling around 30,000 to 40,000 mph. As it traveled through the atmosphere, the air around it heated up as much as 50,000 degrees Fahrenheit, causing the comet to look like a giant fireball streaking through the sky. Eventually, this also caused the comet to annihilate itself around 5 miles above the Earth's surface in fiery blast that consumed the comet, which was largely made of ice. Thank you.
Thank you. That was a good story. Finally, I hope you people understand what the assignment was. You just had to pick an event and tell me what happened in the event, and this is exactly what I want when I told you that I have a historical storytelling assignment. Good job, Myra. And Hemant, your turn.
Okay, ma'am, I'm ready.
Yes.
हम आज कहानी सुनाने वाले हैं पृथ्वीराज चौहान की.
पृथ्वीराज चौहान तो कल ही तो सुनी मैंने. ना 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 ना. There has to be no repetition. I'll give you another chance. मैं तुमसे next class में फिर से पूछूंगी. Find something else. अक्षरा, योर टर्न.
यस मैम. देयर इज नॉट डिफाइंड हिस्ट्री अबाउट द बर्थ ऑफ अलाउद्दीन खिलजी. इवन थ्रू इन 1250 एडी इट्स बर्थ वॉज टोल्ड इन हिस्ट्री. अलाउद्दीन खिलजी फादर ओल्ड मोहम्मद खिलजी वॉज द ब्रदर ऑफ Jalaluddin chose Khilji, the first ruler of Khilji dynasty. In the way, the first ruler of Khilji dynasty, Jalaluddin Khilji, was the uncle of Alauddin Khilji and loved him a lot. That is why during the rule of Sultan Jalaluddin Khilji, Alauddin Khilji had been given the rule to given the rule of Khara. Not only this, he was kept ahead of the war against Malwa. Alauddin increased his strength and took position of a Deccan, of the Deccan. Along with this, he had captured the Khara Desh. He grated all the goods of loot and returned back to Khara. 1296 AD, Alauddin Khilji saluted his own uncle in the greeted of power. After this, he joined the entire minister and declared himself a new Sultan of Delhi.
That was all?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I'll fill in. I would like to fill in some details on your side. When Alauddin Khilji, when Jalaluddin Khilji was exactly not the ruler of Delhi, he was a chieftain in Afghanistan. And during that time, he married his daughter to his nephew, that was Alauddin Khilji. And as he became Sultan, the daughter, she became a prideful. It is said that she became prideful and she started mistreating her husband. And because of that, the husband, that was Alauddin Khilji, he started taking more interest in the warfare than staying at home. And while he was there, he turned out to be a good military commander. He grew in confidence, and over the time, he realized that he thought that he was a better ruler than his uncle, and so he decided to take up the throne for himself. But how should he do that? So when he was the governor of Khara is basically the modern day Allahabad. When he became the governor of Khara, he led an expedition to Devgiri. From Devgiri, he bought a lot of treasures. It was a very big win. And when he bought the treasures back, he stayed in Khara instead of going to Delhi. Usually the convention was that all the loot, all the treasure that they have taken should have gone directly to the Sultan. But the Sultan summoned him, when he was going in his way to Delhi, while he was going, he decided that now it is time to take up the kingdom. So he started distributing whatever wealth he had got from Devgiri to the people on the way. रस्ते में जाते जाते सबको वो पैसे देता चला गया दैट ओके सपोर्ट मी आई विल बिकम योर न्यू रूलर आई विल बिकम योर सुल्तान सपोर्ट मी सो बेसिकली ही लूटेड मनी फ्रॉम देवगिरी डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड इट अमंग पीपल टू गेन देयर सपोर्ट एंड व्हाइल ही गेन देयर सपोर्ट बाय द टाइम ही रीच दिल्ली ही हैड अ लॉट ऑफ सपोर्ट एंड ही इजिली डिकैपिटेटेड एंड किल्ड द सुल्तान एंड बिकेम द नेक्स्ट रूलर बट डूइंग दैट ही रियलाइज्ड दैट इफ आई कैन विन द थ्रोन यूजिंग मनी Anybody can do that. So the first thing he did was he took away the money to the people he gave for support. He impoverished the nobility basically. He put a lot of tax on the goods and he had so many spies everywhere and the punishments were so tough, so stringent at that time that people were so afraid of him ki diwaron ke bhi kaan hote hain, he should not be able to listen to the criticism of his government. He ruled with an iron fist. He believed in the practice of treating the ruler as like a godlike something, and he insisted that people should bow down to him, but the Muslim community or the Muslim religion at that time believed that every human being is equal and nobody should be treated specifically or especially. So he broke that convention, and he realized that keeping the nobles happy will only give them power. He instead started keeping the common people happy. What do common people want? They just want food and some good life. So whatever the strict taxes were, they were imposed on luxury items rather than the need, the items of need. He especially created an area in Doab. Doab means the region of Ganga and Jamuna, which was used for the cultivation of wheat, and that wheat was used to feed the army that he created in Delhi, he created forts in Delhi, he created strong army. Ab army wahan par hai, army will need food, people will need food. If people have food, people are happy. If people are happy, they do not revolt against you. During his time, he introduced many reforms for the general welfare of the people, but he kept all his nobles in check. And but because of all this kind of things, he became very paranoid. It is said that he had his favorite, I don't exactly remember his name. What was his name? Kya naam tha uska? Jiske saath wo ghumta rehta tha. That slave.
Ma'am, kaun?
Malik Kafur. Yes, Malik Kafur. Malik Kafur became a very powerful person at his time. He even poisoned Sultan against his own wife and children. And it is said that he went ahead and won till Madurai. Madurai tak jaake he won the land for Delhi Sultanate. But when he came back, he felt like he could be Sultan. So probably he poisoned him. And but the nobles, they were not trustworthy of him. So again, his wife and son, they took over control and executed him, Malik Kafur. But Malik Kafur was also a very powerful person at this time because he enjoyed the favor of Sultan. So he was not exactly as barbaric and not that bad of a person that history portrays him. He was actually kind of an intelligent ruler. He worked for the welfare of the people. He was brutal. He was ruthless in killing people, but so was pretty much every other ruler at that time. Okay, so I think that should be all for today. Thank you, Sairam, and we will continue both these things in the next class.
Sairam, ma'am.
Sairam, ma'am.
Sairam, ma'am.